Hi, my name is Nadun Subhasingha. I'm 25 years old and I'm an Instagram influencer and a businessman as well. And I have my own floral clothing line. It's called Sunny Side Up. Okay, so that's a bit of a tough question because I've been working out roughly for like 5 to 6 years. But it all started when I was really obese and I was like 125 kilos. And then my dad had kind of a heart attack and I got really nervous about fitness and stuff and I got into it. So roughly 5 to 6 years, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I have a workout buddy. His name is Varsha Sharma. He's like, right now in my lifetime, he's the one who's always giving me so much motivation to do it. And yeah, I think without him, I would be pretty bored working out. I work out roughly 4 to 5 days a week, but sometimes if it's like with intense extra cardio and abs, I would do 6 days a week. But I would recommend to anyone who's doing cardio workouts, just do 4 to 5. That should be enough for you. It's mainly my dad's heart attack. So I was 19, 20, and I was like 125 obese. And all these nurses at the hospital were telling me that you look way too fat and you might get a heart attack by the time you're 25, you know? And then it hit me really hard and I just started pushing myself and I got to a point where I was 12% body fat and 8-pack and the whole package. But the thing is, last whole year has been a bit intense for me life-wise, so I lost touch of it and now I'm getting back on track and now I'm pushing. It's mainly motivation and your mindset. Like, if you can set your mind to anything, you can do whatever you want. Hydration is one of the main factors when you work out. Even if you don't work out, it should be a main thing in your life. You should have roughly 1 to 2 liters of water at least. I personally have maybe 3-4 liters of water because when I work out, I sweat a lot. So hydration is very important when you're working out because your muscles get stiff and you tend to get more injuries. So it's a very important thing in life. The best part of training for me is my mindset and my goals. Like, in the morning when I come in, get a workout with my buddy, like, anything that I do after is so easy. Like, I get so motivated to do it and the pump is real, you know, like after proper workout, your blood just rushes through your brain and your body. Like, anything you set your mind to it, you can do it. Like, that's my main thing for working out right now in life. For me, mainly just a lot of cardio machines as well, because I was an obese kid and cardio is like one of the main things. Even though people hate doing cardio, you know, you got to do your cardio. It's like a main thing in life, but mainly equipments like free weights and other equipments like chest press, like whatever that helps you build up your body is fine, but mainly weights. It should be there. It's a must, like heavy weights. Right now, no, but I always have my own physiotherapy, so I go to him time to time and get it checked. Like last week I had a knee injury, like I had a bit of water in my knee because I was overweight, so I can't push it, but not a lot of medical advice that way, just I'm cautious myself, so it should be all right. There are some days I don't want to come, like I call my buddy like Varsha and I'm like, bro, like, you know, today we'll just call it a chill day, you know, like I'll go, but then he'll be like, bro, are you sure, like, you want to go? But there are days in life like you get so demotivated to work out. Of course it happens to anyone, but I think those are the best days for a workout, you know. It's really important, like you need to rest at least a couple of days a week for your muscles to build up, because if you just keep stretching and like just stressing your whole body throughout the week, you don't have recovery time. So recovery time is one of the most important things while working out. It's like a must. Everyone should know that. So people looking for motivation to work out, like, just get it out there, you know, just go to the gym, push yourself, get out of the comfortable zone, like just make yourself feel more uncomfortable, and then in time you'll get more comfortable in gym. And then like me, like I was so fat throughout, like high school I was so lean, then I got so obese, but then I pushed myself. Like, I didn't go to the gym like this. I was so fat, people are looking at me and they were like, wow, you're really fat and stuff. But I lost 50 kilos in over a year. So if I can do it, you can do it. Just push yourself, go past that uncomfortable zone, just get comfortable with your body and just push it. Like, it's easy, it's just all mindset. Like, just you set your mind and your targets in life, you can get anything done. It's easy as that. it's not like one of the most hectic or like big stretch workings, but I just like just stretch my arms first. So this is my final bicep exercise. I'm gonna do concentrated bicep curl. So I'm a body bar guy, so this is where I normally have my workouts in. So today I'm gonna have a back and arms workout. So let's see how it goes. I'm just gonna warm up a bit and work on the arms and back. All right. All right, guys. So this is where I normally do my cardio. This is the cardio section of the gym part. So right now I'm gonna do a bit of treadmill before I warm up. So just like maybe 5 to 10 minutes and just get myself warmed up a bit. So guys, now I'm doing treadmill cardio. So normally people do like very fast paced running in it, but for me, I would like to do like a moderate amount of speed with a bit of incline, so it just gets all my legs and all my muscles stretched out and warmed up for the next exercises. Because if I push myself a lot more in this, I'll just sweat out and get more like tired before the workout. So right now I just want to warm up. So just gonna get all my legs, arms, everything, just a bit of stretching and just get my heart rate going out, you know. Let's see how it goes. Not too fast, but just like at a moderate rate. Alright guys, so now I'm done with my warming up. I did 10 minutes of treadmill cardio. So right now I'm just gonna do arms and back. So I'm just gonna go stretch and warm up for my next set. See how it goes. Alright guys, so now I'm just gonna do a bit of stretching and just get warmed up, stretch all my muscles before I do a proper workout. Oh my God. Stretch my arms first. This is not like one of the most hectic or like big stretch workings, but I just like just stretch my arms first. Because every time when I do a hard workout, all the muscles tend to get more stiff. Hi guys, so our first exercise is gonna be deadlifts today. So this is my workout buddy Varsha Sharma. So we are both gonna do maybe 245 pace to warm up with and maybe 3 sets of deadlift. This hits the whole body. It's like a full body workout if you start anything. So right now we're just gonna put 245 plates. And then just gonna start the workout. Alright, just gonna do maybe 10 to 15 depending on how I feel the weight. So I did one set of 245 plates. Now I'm gonna add an extra plate onto this, like 245s on each side, and gonna go a bit heavy. So like I said earlier, this is a really good full body workout before you do it, and it takes a lot of out of you as well. But you can push yourself to get more weight. And it's really good, like when you push it, like I did 15 sets on the first set. On this set I did 8, maybe another 8 set to just finish it off. Oh. So that was my last set and it was so intense. I'm just gonna go for lateral pull downs now and just lateral pull downs and just gonna work out on my upper back area. Let's go there and see it. Alright guys, so I'm up to my second exercise now. It's lateral pull down. First I'm going to do maybe 10 sets with a warm up with low weight, and then we're going to do like 8 to 10. So I'm just going to warm up with it. So I'm done with my first set. It was a low weight, high rep set. Now I'm going to increase the weight maybe to 9 bar, and then gonna do like maybe 10 to 15 reps, and that'll be my last set for this exercise. Alright, so I'm done with this exercise now. I've done two exercises for my back. So this one mainly hits your lateral area, this area, and it's for the upper back as well. So try to do high reps. I did 9 plates. So if you're doing 9 plates or more, just try to do lower reps and try to build more muscle. But if you want to cut it down, go low weight, higher reps. So right now, done with this. Just gonna go for a bit of lower back area exercises. I'm gonna start with that now. All right guys, so this is long bar rowing. I'm gonna put a 45 plate to start with. All right. Just gonna put one now. Gonna do a wide grip on this, and it's mainly for lower back and middle back. Alright, done with one set. Gonna do another set, maybe 10 to 15 reps. Same plate maybe, because my back muscle is already stressed from doing deadlifts today. So this is going to be my last back exercise. Maybe two more sets and I'll be good to go. That was my final set, and I'm done with back now. It hit my lower back and middle back mainly, and I think my laterals are probably pumped as well now. Now I'm just going to do a bit of biceps, maybe 3 exercises, and let's see how it goes. Alright guys, so this is my 4th exercise and I'm doing biceps right now. Just gonna do dumbbell preacher. Alright. Normally you can do higher reps on this. So for me, like I said, I've lost fitness for almost a year now. And even my bicep curls are still like, the nugget is building up. So I do mainly low weight, but high reps. So cut down my fat. So what I did was 15 to 20 kilos, just like 30 sets roughly, you know. Just 10 warm up, 15, then another 5 to just finish off. Mainly trying to fail it and build the muscle mass. That's the main thing for this. So I might do another extra rep and just finish it off. Alright, so I'm done with 3 sets of these guys. Got a bit heavy, still building the muscle. So right now I'm gonna go for easy bar bicep curl. Just gonna do 3 sets of that and then finish it off with a concentrated bicep curl. And then we are gonna call it quits on the arms. And then final exercise will be tire flipping. See what's happening next. Right. Alright, so this is my 5th exercise for biceps. It's gonna be easy bar bicep curl. Alright, so that was 15 reps for the first set on pretty decent weight. And I'm gonna do 2 more sets for it and see how it goes, because already the pump is good on the arms. Can do one more exercise, maybe 2 more sets with 15 reps each, should be good. So I did my last set, maybe 15 reps, just on high weight, just keeping the tension high on it, and I kind of failed on the muscle as well. So this is done with the last exercise. Actually, we might do one more exercise with the concentrated bicep curl, then call it quits on the arms. So this is my final bicep exercise. I'm gonna do concentrated bicep curl. Manami.
Let's start it like this.
So this exercise mainly concentrates on your nugget part, like the main bicep curl on it. And when you do higher reps on it, it just hits this area more. And when you end up doing it with a single arm, you can concentrate more on one arm. And even if you fail, you can just push it back with your other arm. Because sometimes your left arms tend to get weaker, depending on which arm you ride with or something. But when your weak arm gets to fail, you can just like push it a bit more. Like let's say for example, it's failing on this part, you can just like push it. So like you can always get a full rep on it. So it's really good for your biceps when you do that exercise. See, like I told you, my left arm is more weaker than the right, so I had to support it with my right arm. So mainly we do these kind of exercises for our backs, bicep, chest, tricep, anything, because free weights are really good for you. Like long term wise, free weights help you build more muscle and body balance. So because of that, like all the exercises we did today, if you look back, you realize that everything has been related to free weights. So I recommend anyone who's doing workouts, trying to get into fitness, go with free weights because it's the best thing to do. And we are done with all the workouts here today. We are going to do one more tire flip. That's going to hit the whole body and then just like call it quits. I'm going to go eat a good meal. See how it goes. Alright guys, this is going to be my last and final exercise. I'm just going to be doing a tire flip. So this tire is 150 kilos. This tire is 250 kilos. Right now I'm just going to do the 150 kilo tire flips up and down. Maybe three sets non-stop, so it's going to be higher reps, mainly concentrated on arms, legs and everything. It's just a full body workout, but you have to do the right posture. So you have to do like a squat position and then raise it with upper body strength and lower body strength, and you have to push it up. So I'll show you how it's done. So this is my last flip. I'm going to try maybe two or three flips with this. This is pretty heavy, 250 kilos. I'm going to try two to three flips on this and then just going to do one hand flip on the 150 and just finish it off. Let's see how it goes. Is intense. The thing is, it's very hard to hold from this point of view because your fingers get stuck on it. So I had to hold it from this angle. But six of those takes a lot out of you. It's 250 kilos. Just gonna push it. I'm just gonna finish it off with maybe five of these and just call it quick. So this is my last set and my last exercise for the whole day. I'm just gonna do one arm tire flips right now. My buddy Vaish is gonna do full flips on the 250 kg. Just gonna do 5-5 each, just call it quits. Right. Alright guys, so that's it for my workouts. Done with everything, did my lower backs, arms, tire flips and everything. Just gonna call it a day. Gonna go have some food at Pio Kitchen. They make my favorite food there. You're gonna see what it is next. I'm just gonna have a good time. So hope you guys had a good time watching me. Enjoy guys. Hi guys, so now I'm at PO Kitchen. This food, like you can replace it for rice mainly. Hi guys, so now I'm at PO Kitchen. This is where I normally come to have post-workout meals. And right now I'm gonna order what I'm gonna have. Hi, how's it going? Yeah, so can I get one power berry, and I'll be getting a bowl of quinoa rice, prawns and one egg. That'll be my meal. So how much is the amount?
That's 1,900.
Okay, here you go. Alright, thank you. So it's gonna take a couple of minutes for the order to be processed, so I'm gonna stay here for a while. Let's see how it goes. Alright guys, so my meal is here. It's mainly quinoa fried rice with prawn devil, and I got one of those power berries. It's really good after a post-workout. So if you want to try this food out, it's mainly at PO Kitchen, and you can always come and try it. They're open most of the time and just close on weekends, I think. So I'm just going to try it and see how it is. It's really good. I always have this meal after workout, and if you guys are trying to cut down on carbs and fat, just these kind of meals are really good for you, because it's mainly healthy quinoa with broccoli and all these other goodies mixed into it, and it's just prawns and other veggies. Alright, so this food, like, you can replace it for rice mainly. Alright. Some people don't like to have a lot of rice in their meals because it's a lot of carbs, right? So these kind of meals, when you have it with quinoa, it's a perfect replacement for rice. Like, and it's low on carbs as well. And protein gives the right amount of protein you need as well. Like, normally I would add an egg, maybe some fish as well for high protein if I'm on a heavy workout. Today I just had back and arms, so it was all right. And this is a power berry smoothie. It's mainly with protein and low sugar, like actually no sugar at all, and it's a perfect recovery drink after a good workout. I'm just gonna head out now and just gonna call it a day. Done with my workout, had an awesome meal. Perfect meal actually. Just gonna go and have a good day. Alright. Alright guys, that's it for my workout today. And hope you guys had a good time with me. And thanks Hi TV and MyFitLife for having me. It was an awesome time. And hope you guys learned something out of my workouts from this session and my diet plans as well. And this is the gym I work at Body Bar. And hope you guys had an awesome time. And my Instagram tag is Nadun93, and I'll see you guys next time.